You know how to launch a prospecting campaign on Waalaxy, but now you would like to know how it works more in details? Hi, Karen here, and today I'm explaining you how Waalaxy campaigns work from launch to results. So if you're watching this video, you're supposed to know how to use Waalaxy, more or less. If not, I suggest you to first watch my video on how to launch your first Waalaxy campaign. The link is in the description. Now let's move on to the sequences. As you may have noticed, when you launch your Waalaxy campaign, there's a lot of choice in prospecting sequences. Actually, we've tried to create as many sequences as possible so that you're sure to find what you want. So if you're not sure which campaign to choose, you have two options. The simplest, you can answer two or three questions that will apply filters that seem too much to help you find the ideal prospecting sequence for you. Alternatively, you can simply filter manually or directly search for your sequence in the search bar if you know its name. So you can filter by whether your prospect is part of your LinkedIn network or not, whether you want to prospect by email, by LinkedIn or both, but also by the actions you want to perform on your prospect or by the number of LinkedIn messages or emails that will be sent during the prospecting campaign. Filters only work in inclusion. So if you select CRM synchronization, email finder and to send an email, for instance, it will only show you sequences that have the three steps in questions, not just one of them. And if despite all that, you're still not sure which sequence to choose, you can always go for the most frequently used one. Now, let's assume that your campaign is up and running. There's no limit to the number of campaigns running, so you can have several running simultaneously. However, there is a limit to the number of leads you can have in one campaign. I'll leave you an article in the description with the limits in questions. In any case, once your campaign has been launched, your actions go in the queue. You can see them right there. These actions respect random daily quotas and the FIFO method, which means first in, first out. So this means that if you launch a campaign A with 200 connection requests and then a campaign B with 300 messages, Waalaxy will first execute the connection requests up to the last quota you have for the day. Then it will be the messages turn. Waalaxy will run these actions until you don't have quotas anymore for messages. Quotas will be reset the following day and connection requests will once again be sent in priority as you launched campaign A first. And they will be followed by messages from campaign B once the quota has been reached. And the same principle will be applied independently until all actions have been sent. If your campaign includes several steps, don't be afraid if you don't see the actions in the queue. You can see the status of your prospects directly from the campaign. Here, my campaign has three stages. It visits the prospect's profile, then one day later, it sends a connection request, and then the message will be sent 2 days after the prospect accepts the connection request, regarding they didn't reply. So when I launch my campaign, the first step goes in the queue. Once the prospect has received the first action, which here is a visit, they'll enter the delay step. So Waalaxy will wait for the delay between the first and second action to be reached before to send the second action in the queue. After the invitation has been sent to the prospect, here the delay time will work differently because you have to wait for the prospect to accept the connection request for the delay to start. So only after acceptance will the 2 day delay start and then the prospect will be queued for the last action. And after receiving the last action, which is a message, the tool will take a certain amount of time before exiting the prospect of the campaign. This is to help you because if the prospect replies in less than 5 days after the last message, their answer will count in the acceptance rate in the campaign, which is essential for analyzing your performance. But so if we come back to the story of the queue, what I said raises an important point. The more campaigns you run at the same time or the more campaigns you supply, the more actions you will have to send. So you can have fun, let's say launch 5,000 prospects in 2 or 3 campaigns, and your prospecting will be automating for months. That's the cool thing. But there is something less cooler. You will have to be careful if you have a campaign about a certain event. Let's say you have an event in 2 weeks. You may have to post campaigns for this campaign to be prioritized. In any case, let me reassure you. If we assume that our campaign A, we talked about earlier, has a message that will be sent after the invitation. When the second step of the campaign A is added to the queue, it will take priority over the campaign B's actions. Basically, N+1 actions are given priority to guarantee a delay close to the one announced between your 2 actions. Now that the queue is clear, how about deciphering campaigns? First of all, as you can see, there are 3 different color circles. Green means you've got actions queued. Orange means you've got leads in progress, but no actions queued, so your leads are probably waiting for a condition or a deadline. And red means you've got no leads in progress in your campaign right now. You can therefore add prospects in the campaign if you wish, or pause the campaign. As I explained, pausing campaigns removes actions from the queue, moving the next actions to the front. In this case, if you restart the campaign, the actions will be added at the very bottom of the queue, which can be a good way to change prioritization in your campaigns. On the other hand, if you don't want to use a campaign anymore, you can archive it. But remember that it's not possible to launch again a campaign that was archived, so think twice before doing so. In the same way, you can pause or remove prospects from your campaign. So let's say you want to contact certain prospects as a priority, or simply stop prospecting on certain prospects. You can pause or exit them directly from your campaign. For instance, I'm not sure I want to contact my prospects in the Google list. I can pause these prospects. You can see the number of paused leads by going on the details. That way, later on, you will be able to relaunch them into the campaign whenever you want. They'll pick up where they left off. And on the contrary, if you're sure that you don't want to prospect them anymore, you can exit them from the campaign. But in that case, if you move them back to the campaign again, they will start from scratch. So in a campaign, you can see how many prospects there are, whether they're prospects currently in progress, paused prospects, or prospects that exited the campaign. You can filter your prospects by list, by tag, by the prospect's current step in the campaign, the prospect status, or directly search for them in the search bar. You can also tag prospects directly from the campaign or export your prospect's data. Now it's time to look at the campaign results. Depending on how long your campaign has been running or if you want to make a precise analysis, you can change the periodicity of your results. In any case, if your campaign is multi-channel, you will be able to see the results via LinkedIn and email separately. For LinkedIn, you will have a table from which you can see the number of actions sent in the campaign and when they were sent. You'll also have access to your acceptance rate, which includes all the invitations accepted in the campaign, and the response rate, which takes into account the replies to your connection requests and messages. In fact, in the top right-hand corner of the campaign, you will see the response rate of your campaign on the long term. Hovering your mouse over it, you will be able to see whether your rate is satisfactory or not for our tool. And if you've just launched your campaign, don't worry, it's normal to have a low response rate at the beginning, so wait a few days before to look at it. About emails, you can see the number of emails sent, but above all, you can see how many replies you had and how many emails have been delivered or not. Because yes, this is something that can happen. An email may not be delivered for a lot of reasons. Most of the time, these or business emails, so this is totally normal that someone doesn't have it anymore. Don't worry, in this case, you will receive an email informing you that the email hasn't been able to be sent. In any case, whether your campaign is on LinkedIn, by email, or both, you will be able to download your data in CSV this way. This will enable you to see the results in the table day by day in the period of your choice, which is a real plus if you want to analyze your results from your side. And after that, it's up to you to analyze your results on your own. And there you have it. If you liked the video, consider subscribing. It's always a pleasure. And of course, if you have any questions, I'm waiting for you in the comment section below. See you soon for more videos.